In the mid-1970s, Jan Buczek, a lecturer at the Technological University of Zielona Góra, built the prototype of the first Polish hillside tractor based on the design of serial Ursus C330. It was estimated at that time that even up to 2 million hectares of land in mountainous areas lay fallow in Poland. Jan Buczek wanted to solve this problem and do something to transform this land into fields. The machine has been deeply tested on the fields of state-owned farms, where it passed all the tests and received positive feedback from farm managers, who were willing to order even several copies of the tractor right away. Unfortunately, this project never entered mass production, and Jan Buczek, apart from wasted several years of hard work, also suffered political persecution, and as a result he was forced to leave Poland and move to Canada. In today's episode, I'm going to tell you a sad story of a forgotten Polish hillside tractor created by Jan Buczek. It will be a story about how during the communist era in Poland, creative people were blocked from implementing their own initiatives and how our Polish automotive and machinery industry had been blocked by Moscow. My name is Mateo, welcome to my channel. I am a farmer and tractor enthusiast from Poland, introducing you to this amazing world of tractors and heavy machinery. If you like my videos, be sure to hit that thumb up button and subscribe to my channel in order not to miss any of my new videos. And now, without further ado, let's jump into the story. Who needs all this crap? Who has the health to think of a tractor when the world is shaking to its foundations? It's November 1980. We already have Ferguson. It's better, Western. As for root crops, Canada will give us wheat and the United States swore corn in contract. So why this noise? The idea of creating a hillside tractor adapted to work on slopes was born in the mind of Jan Buczek during his studies at the Gdańsk University of Technology. The first works on the tractor started around 1975, when Jan Buczek started working at the Institute of Machine Building of the University of Technology in Zielona Góra. Buczek gathered a group of co-workers around him, and despite the reluctance and lenient treatment of his superiors, they began to develop documentation of the tractor. These works were carried out in partial secrecy, after hours without support from the university. Jan Buczek financed the project mostly out of his own pocket, and his colleagues were even afraid to admit that they participate in the project. Despite numerous letters to the university authorities, the Ministry of Agriculture or the Ursus Mechanical Plants, Buczek failed to receive support in the form of a tractor on the basis of which he could develop a prototype of his own construction. Finally, he managed to organize a used Ursus C330 from junkyard, on the basis of which a prototype was created. The tractor was created on the basis of the Ursus C330 manufactured by Polish Ursus Tractor Plant. The parts needed for the hillside implementation were created and delivered by the State Machinery Center in Sieniawa. In socialist Poland, state machinery centers used to be some kind of state workshops where tractors and machines were repaired and modernized in the past. Today they are gone, there are only private workshops like in most of capitalist countries. Jan Buczek's hillside tractor had a Polish-made two-cylinder liquid-cooled engine with a capacity of less than 2 liters, generating power of about 30 HP. In terms of technical parameters, the tractor did not differ from a serial Ursus C330. However, what made it stand out was the chassis structure, designed from scratch and adapted to work on slopes. An average ordinary tractor should be able to work on slopes not exceeding 10 degrees of inclination. Modified tractor by Jan Buczek enabled comfortable and safe work on slopes with an inclination of up to 40 degrees. The front and the rear axles changed their position to compensate for the slope, thanks to which the body of the tractor, together with the operator's position, always remained level. When the tractor tilted, the oil in a special tank changed its position, which activated the hydraulic distributor to supply more oil to the cylinder on one of the sides. It was even simpler solution than in the American Natson Hillside Tractor discussed in the one of my previous episodes, because it didn't require advanced electronics. What's more, in order to avoid slipping of the rear wheels, an additional steering mechanism has been implemented, allowing the rear wheels to tilt up to 10 degrees. When the prototype was finished, it was time to carry out the necessary research and the test on the structure in order to eliminate potential design errors and introduce corrections. And if you think that it was the end of the inventor's problems, you are wrong. Throwing up roadblocks was just about to begin. A special test bench was needed to test the tractor in laboratory conditions. Of course, the university authorities refused to allow such a thing to be carried out within the walls of their facility. However, Jan Buczek finally managed to find a plant that would undertake the construction of a specialized test station. This plant turned out to be the lignite mine in Bogatynia. Yes, no other institution in Poland, including the Polish universities and engineering schools, could or rather would not want to undertake this task. And so, in the meantime, a movable test bench was being created in the mine workshops, which was to enable testing the tractor in laboratory conditions. When the stand was ready, the university authorities did not want to agree to place it in the halls of the laboratory of the university. After numerous complaints, they finally let go and Jan Buczek was able to continue working on his tractor. The tractor, apart from laboratory test, also went to several state-owned farms where engineer Jan Buczek personally performed work on the slopes, such as plowing, sowing or harrowing. The machine received a positive recommendation from farm managers, who even wanted to order several copies of such a tractor for the needs of their farms. It was about hundreds, maybe even thousands of hectares, which were then worked with horses or not worked at all. However, despite this, Jan Buczek's letters to the university and other state authorities remained unanswered.
Proszę pana, ciągnik ten wykonywał pracę tutaj właśnie na tych polach, na tym terenie górzystym i zdał egzamin bardzo dobrze. I uważam, że gdybyśmy w gospodarstwie taki ciągnik posiadali, to zlikwidowalibyśmy wszystkie te nieużytki na górach, których dotychczas nie obsiewamy. A moglibyśmy to z powodzeniem obsiać i ja bym na taki ciągnik z miejsca reflektował dla gospodarstwa, ponieważ on jest koniecznie potrzebny.
Jan Buczek decided to get the media interested in his hillside tractor. First, the editor Leon Gąsior from Gazeta Lubuska newspaper became interested in the case. He publicized the article and asked the university authorities why nothing was happening in the case of the hillside tractor, to which the university has the rights, because Jan Buczek was only an employee. Unfortunately, he did not receive a specific answer. As a result, Jan Buczek was fired from work under the pretext of lack of achievements in scientific work, just a few weeks after the publication of the article. It was obviously a hoax, because apart from several years of work on the construction of his hillside tractor, Jan Buczek also created many other studies. It was a decision clearly aimed at removing disobedient employee from the university and in response to the publicity of the case in the media. Soon after, the engineer's wife also lost her job at the university. After another media intervention in TV, Jan Buczek was reinstated to his post. In the meantime, at his alma mater, the Gdańsk University of Technology, he managed to defend his doctoral thesis entitled Construction of an Agricultural Tractor to Work on Slopes. The thesis received a distinction and an excellent review by Professor Nowakowski and Professor Edmund Kosecki from the University of Agriculture and Technology in Olsztyn. Despite this, neither the Zielona Góra University authorities, nor the Ministry of Agriculture, nor Ursus Tractor Plant did not respond to any suggestions of Jan Buczek. The project never came out, and few years later, Jan Buczek was forced to leave Poland because of political persecution. He moved to Canada, where together with other Polish engineers forced to escape Poland, they started producing machines for metalworking.
Praca po schodach, pod górę, ciągle pod górę. Uważam, że 80% czasu, który włożyłem, to czas poświęcony na sprawy formalne, których ja nie powinien wykonywać. 20% czasu natomiast poświęciłem praktycznie tej konstrukcji.
Jan Buczek returned back home to Poland in 2004, where he started a new company dealing in the production of car washes. He won numerous awards for the best design of car wash. Now he is retired and he lives in the northwest part of Poland. This story I presented you today took place more than 40 years ago. At that time, communism had fallen, Poland regained its independence, but I still have an irascible impression that despite the passage of years, not much has changed. Poland is nowadays an independent country, part of European Union and NATO ally, but in our country still you can see the influence of the old system, because a large number of politicians, officials, judiciary and judges remain the same as in communist period. And that's why bureaucracy still blocks our Polish potential and development of Polish industry. We used to have a lot of tractor, machinery or automotive brands like Ursus, FMZ Bison, Crystal, Ślązak, Pronar, Jelcz, Star, HSW, Waryński and so on, but now most of them went bankrupt or changed their production because of legal and economic problems. That's sad, but I hope that us, the young generation of Poles, will be able to rebuild our heavy industry in the future and cooperate with companies all over the world. And that's all in today's episode. I hope you like my video. If so, be sure to leave a thumb up and subscribe to my channel in order not to miss any of my new videos. I also invite you to join our Facebook group Mateo Machinery for more interesting content from the world of tractors and heavy machinery. And now thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye!